Hello and welcome back. I'm going to discuss the invoice tracker today because somebody rightly pointed out that if I now enter data into my invoice and click on store customer data, then this data would also be stored in the customer's worksheet. Now we already have Larry Holmes. So how can we avoid that if we enter Larry Holmes again with the same phone number, email address and so on, that on clicking on the store customer data, this should not be stored again? So I'll show you that in action now before we discuss the code. So I click on this store customer data and I say yes, enter, and you see that data has not been stored again. That means we can now avoid adding duplicate customer details. So let's go to the developer tab and let's look at the change that we have done in the Visual Basic code. In the store customers, most of the coding is the same, except that we now run a for loop after the input box. That means when we ask the user to enter yes or no. So what do we do here? As soon as the looping process finds that the company name exists, then it exits the for loop and doesn't add the relevant data, doesn't change the company ID, and just goes out of the loop. But in case the company name doesn't match, then of course it adds the data as required. Let's do that. So we'll go to the Excel worksheet. So in the invoice worksheet, instead of Larry Holmes, let's add Betty Davis. And just to save time, I'm not going to change any of this data. That means the address, the contact name and so on. So let's click on the store customer data now. We'll say yes in the input box, enter. Let's go to the customer's worksheet and you see if the company name is different, then alone this data is added. I hope you found this interesting and useful. Thanks for watching.